everyone. Today I wanted to just quickly talk about the Booktubeathon and the 24 and 48 hour readathon, both of which just finished yesterday on Sunday. I participated in both and I thought I would just share my experience during the readathon and what I managed to read during the readathon. I think the biggest thing is that this was the first readathon that I participated in as a fully employed adult. I participated in readathons in the past where I was a student and when I was fun employed. Sometimes I had more time, sometimes I had less time, but right now I have a pretty average schedule. I work a 9-to-5, I do most of my reading during my commute to and from work, and I don't have as much freedom to read as I used to, which is a little bit sad. I also had a company function and some social stuff planned, so I wasn't able to devote all of my free time to reading, but I still managed to finish 5 things and start a 6th, so I feel like that's pretty good. I was in the middle of a couple of things when I started the readathon, first being Cloud Atlas by David Mitchell. I was at about the 100 page mark when the readathon started, so I read over 400 pages from this book during the readathon, and it took me most of the week to get through this. This is what I was reading to and from work, and also a little bit at night. And it really honestly slowed me down a lot. I wish that I had read things that were easier to read, faster, and shorter. And that's not to say that Cloud Atlas is a dense read, nor is it particularly challenging, but there are sections that are more challenging than others, particularly the 6th section, which was written in a dialect that required a lot of my focus and attention. And unfortunately, because I take public transit to work, I'm slightly distracted and things can pull me out of the narrative a bit. And this was something that took a little bit of time to get into. Once you were kind of in the flow and the vernacular of the dialect, it was a lot easier to follow and understand. But if I got distracted, I had to be reacclimated to the writing style. And I experienced the same thing in between reading sessions. I had to readjust and refigure out what was going on and readjust to the language. And that's all to say that this was not the best readathon read, but I am glad to now have finished it. I just probably should have picked up something else or waited on this one. The other thing that I was in the middle of at the beginning of the readathon was The Brief Letters, Life of Oscar Wilde, which I was listening to on audiobook. I was about halfway through it when the readathon started. It's about a 12-hour audiobook, so I listened to a good portion of it during the readathon. It's a great audiobook. I highly recommend it. I also read Saga Volume 6, which is obviously a trade of a comic that I read. I'm a big fan of Saga. Volume 5 definitely let me down, but I think Volume 6 is now back in the right direction, so I really enjoyed this. I saved it for the readathon, and I'm glad I did, because it was really good. The only other thing that I physically read during the readathon was Homegoing by Yaa Jassy. This was a great readathon read. I highly encourage you to pick it up during a readathon because it's extremely readable, so compelling, and I really, really loved reading it in a extremely confined time period. I read it over the course of about 36 hours, and it was a really interesting way to consume the book because it takes place over the course of 300 years and a generation, so there's a lot going on and you meet a lot of characters, but there was something so immersive about it, and reading it in just a handful of long stints was such an excellent way to consume the story. I'm so glad that I picked this up during the readathon. It's just as good as everyone says it is. I really want to do a review of this and Cloud Atlas in the near future where I can more thoroughly and articulately express my thoughts, so look forward to that. The other couple things I read during the readathon were audiobooks. So I listened to The Bell Jar by Sylvia Plath, which was narrated by Maggie Gyllenhaal. I really enjoyed listening to this audiobook. I mean, as much as you can enjoy listening to The Bell Jar, it's not a happy book, it's extremely depressing. So it was not uplifting, but it was enjoyable. She did a really great job narrating it. I am really happy to now say that I have read it. It was one of those big gaps in my knowledge of American literature, so I'm happy to have read it. I imagine it's something that I will want to reread over and over again, so I have to get myself a physical copy here someday. It's one of those things that I honestly regret not having read sooner. And I also started Home by Marilynne Robinson. I started Home and Homegoing on the same day. This is the second in the Gilead series. They're loosely related, but I'm really glad that I'm reading them in order. I recently finished Gilead, the first one, and I loved the audiobook. There was something about the writing and the rhythm that was really entrancing and made great background noise, which doesn't sound like a great sell, but I do a lot of other things while I'm listening to audiobooks. I usually am not just sitting there and listening, so it is usually background noise for me. And there was something about the rhythm of the book that just made me want to keep listening and was was, like I said, it was kind of entrancing and so wonderful. I really, really enjoyed it. It was something that I would listen to while walking or cooking or cleaning or playing Stardew Valley, and it made the best background noise in the best way possible. I mean, that is an extreme compliment. So that was my readathon experience. I'd love to hear how your readathon went, the successes that you had, the great things that you read. I was really lucky in that I enjoyed everything that I read over the course of the readathon. I've actually been having a really, really strong reading year in general though. Reading as voraciously as I have, I've really developed a great metric for deciding what I will like and won't like, and I'm usually pretty accurate. So most of the books I read this year were 4 stars, and most of the books I read during the readathon were 4-star reads. I would love to hear about what you read, if you found success, if you liked what you read, and I'm looking forward to watching all the wrap-ups and vlogs. Other than that, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.